Praise the Lord. Good day to all of you and welcome to this edition of the Shooter Word. Hi, I'm Pastor Jonathan Ferriol. I'm your host and speaker. The Shooter Word is the outreach ministry on television by the Pentecostal Missionary Church of Christ in the Fort Watch. And this program exists in order to minister to you spiritually. And our aim and our purpose is always to be a blessing to you and to encourage you to grow more in your spiritual relationship with the Lord. The PMCC Fort Watch is a very apostolic and biblical church. This is a church that champions the Word of God, hence our title and name of this program, The Shooter Word. Because if ever there is really something sure these days, and better than sure, is none other than the Word of God and the teachings from the apostles of the Lord Jesus Christ. We champion the Word of God. We preach the Word of God. You can see our missionaries in places where there are concentration of people. In the city of Carson, we preach in front of the seafood, in Compton, in the streets of LA. We preach in this many cities here in South Bay because we believe that the Word of God is what people needed today. Let us now watch and be blessed. I would like to share to you this subject that and this message I entitled Care for the Flock. Care for the Flock. And the Bible declares that before we were brought in to the flock, before we were made to be a sheep in the flock, we used to be lost. We used to be lost sheep. We're not only lost, but we were also harassed. We're helpless and abandoned. In the book of Isaiah, in Isaiah chapter 53, here prophet Isaiah pictures the kind of life we used to live. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. No matter how educated we were, no matter how influential, or no matter how literate we were, those things pale compared to our spiritual condition. Our spiritual conditions was at its very worst. We were lost. We were lost. Regardless of our education, regardless of our knowledge, regardless of our position at work, regardless of who we were, regardless of how good parents we are or how good kids we are, as far as the supreme and high standard of God, all of us are simply lost. And if ever there is something that is frightening to experience, is to be lost. Nobody is happy when he's lost. Nobody is secure when he is lost. Nobody is stable when he is lost. When you are lost, you are vulnerable to all kinds of dangers that exist out there. That's the kind of people we were. But thanks be to God, in his mercies, the good shepherd has brought us all back into his flock. And the flock is no less than the very body of Jesus, which is the church. The church is the flock of God. Acts chapter 20 in verse 28. Acts chapter 20 in verse 28. It says here, "Be shepherds of the church of God, which he bought with his own blood." The church is the flock. And each one of us are the sheep of his pasture, the sheep of his flock. The book of Psalm 100 in verse 3 makes that pretty clear to all of us. It says here in Psalm 100 in verse 3, "Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us,
And we are His. We are His people, the sheep of His pasture. Every single one of us now belongs to the flock of God. We are now the sheep of His pasture. God and Jesus are our shepherds. And so it is in the church, my dear brethren, we can best enjoy the loving kindness of God. There's nowhere else you can enjoy God's loving kindness. There's nowhere else you can fully celebrate and receive the full extent of God's caring and loving shepherding of us, except in the church. There are three things that God does to care for the flock. Three things God does to care for the flock. Number one, He purchased the flock by the life and blood of Jesus. He purchased. That's the reason why God and Christ cares so much for the church. Because we were purchased, we were bought, not with, the Bible says, costly stones. We were not bought with dollar, with money, with any kind of currency. The currency Jesus used to pay us, to acquire us, is His very life. He invested His life on us. And when it is life that is at stake, the equation changes in anything. Pag buhay na ang nakataya, ibang usapan na yan. When it is life that is at stake, definitely that object, that thing, that person that will receive that precious gift of life certainly is truly worth saving. Because why would you give your life for something that is less important than life? Why would you give something so costly for something that is so cheap? Would you give your life to get an ice cream? Would you cross the seven oceans, fight all the alligators and the shark just to get that burrito or churros? You do not spend something beyond, you know, your ability to pay if it is too cheap. You can just let go of it. You can just dismiss it and say, anyway, it's just ice cream. You will not cross the freeway, you know, just to get free breadsticks. Jesus Christ gave His life for us. Because we are more than all the treasures of the world combined. We're more than the wealth of the world. Jesus Christ said, what shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? Mas mahalaga tayo sa lahat ng kayamanan na pinagsama-sama sa sanglibutan. You know, that's why when I think about the costs of evangelizing America, we should not be given to this earthly and secular and carnal feelings. Just like Paul said, we are ready to spend and be spent. We're not here to hoard wealth, to gain wealth. Mahal ang kaligtasan ng kaluluwa. Mahal. It took the very God, the very God's Son, to give His life so that you and I can be saved.